a brutal world, Roberto Duran was the most vicious. They called him Manos de Piedra. He was a born fighter. A warrior.
Panama's international sports star, Duran ran his record to an astonishing 82-1, propelled by a fury few ever possess.
Thank you. I've also noticed that he's thrown a few punches with an open glove. He's slapping, which is a surprise to me with the Hazers. There was another wild punch by the Hazers. Left right hand to Lance, who was a payday punch because he missed it. If it would have landed, it would have been all over. I tell you another thing about Duran, he can miss a punch and you say, aha, you missed me, and he comes back with the other one and you lay it on the floor. He's intense. Until he's loose, this is victory. He's loose. When you're loose, you can punch. When you're tensed up and tight, you don't punch. And when you're tensed up and tight, you can't take a punch.
A minute remaining in the second round. Duran from Guali, Panama. Rinku from Carolina, Puerto Rico. Esteban tried to spin Duran around and keep him off balance. Now Esteban's got to keep doing that. Keep him off balance. Go in and out. And the only shot is going to have to win. Duran is looking to load up and hit him with one hit. Under 30 seconds left in the second round. There it is. Duran keeps punishing Esteban to the body. That will certainly show an effect in the later rounds. If it goes to the later rounds. Esteban's reaching, that's unforgiving. You don't reach for Duran. And he's also slapping with that hook. Final seconds of the second round. Hey! Ranking heavyweight Larry Holmes looking on here in Las Vegas. We mentioned a lot of the fight crowd came in to see this fight if they could get out of the snow from the east and other parts of the country. This is the third round. The Jesus in red, Duran in white. Both fighters got well greased up in the corner. They're throwing fire up at each other and they're trying to get each other out of it. Could be a mistake. When you look for one point, it never comes off. You got to work into the punch. You know, it's rumored that Duran had to take off 15 pounds in 4 weeks to get ready for this fight. And we know both fighters dried out in the law. And I think that could be a deciding factor. Whoever had more trouble making the weight. And as you and I both know, Mayfield had to work right up until the last minute yesterday. So he may have wound up having a bigger problem making the weight than Duran.
That's very true, Greg. And I tell you, what's going to show is the strength in each fighter. Now, the one that got hurt himself by taking the weight off could be the loser. You know, a lot of people may not know what we mean by drying out, Angelo. When a fighter dries out, he usually abstains from liquids for 24 hours or more. And just doing that, he can take off 4 pounds. An average person would take off 4 pounds if they didn't take a drop of liquids in 24 hours.
The Jesus got hurt by that right hand, Greg. This is the third round of the undefeated lightweight world championship. WBC champ to Jesus, WBA champ to Duran. Their third meeting. The Jesus won an odd title fight in 72. Duran, good right hand by De Jesus.
74.
Good right hand. That shook up Duran. Yes, he knew he got hit right on the front. There's that right hand underneath. This is just what we expected. Just what we expected. Just danger territory for Esteban and Mr. Roach.
He sure is
in trouble. That's why I got to stay off the rope. They're both giving each other the arm, pulling each other down. They're really giving each other a number.
Under a minute in the third round, and the crowd loving it here. A packed tennis pavilion at Caesars Palace in Las Vegas.
I tell you, I noticed that Esteban flinched a little bit when Duran fainted. That could be fatal also, Ann. If Duran starts getting the faint, the fall for faint, he's in real bad trouble.
Another smile from the Jesus for Duran.
What is it about Duran? He don't smile. He just keeps buzzing.
Under 30 seconds. These guys look like they're enjoying all this punishment.
Well, they knew the kind of fight was going to be going in, and they're both ready.
There's that southpaw switch you're talking about, man. Final seconds of the third round. Jim Ryan, Angelo Dundee, and Joe Franchi at ringside in Las Vegas for the lightweight championship of the world. Roberto Duran in white, Esteban de Jesus in red, and we are in the fourth round. Any surprises?
No, Esteban
very confident. No surprises. They're both taking plays by the man who's having a good punch. This girl, Esteban, is a calculating. He's slipping and moving. They're not looking for a pay dirt.
got to work into a knockout. You will occasionally see flashes on your television screen. As you might guess, they are from still cameras, some of them from the professionals, but most of them from just fans here in the audience. And there are many, many of them with cameras. These are two of the most exciting fighters in the history of the lightweight division.
I tell you, I don't like the way Esteban is leading with that slapping left hook. If the man counters that punch, it could be all over.
Yeah, but Billy's throwing a beautiful left hook, right hand punch, just like he tried right there. Just a beautiful punch.
The left hook or the right hand.
The right
coming behind to the spine edge. He's slapping with that left hook. He's got to start closing that fist.
There he got counters when he did it then. Here's what Esteban can do. You don't have that in and out movement. You don't have that bounce. You need that bounce against the ring. You got to be able to circle in and out, go both ways.
We want to alert our stations along the line, and we'll be going to a station break at the end of this fourth round. The man is starting to load up a little too much. He's telegraphing his punches.
He's sending a message before he throws the punches.
The man don't get enough credit, though, for being a pretty smart cook in there. He's slipping punches pretty good. He gets under. And, you know, he's supposed to be, have a reputation to be as a slugger. He's a pretty smart cook in there.
Yeah, Don Rice. He didn't become champion just being a slugger. He knows what to do. He moves that head. He slips punches, gets his hands up, and blocks punches.
Under a minute to go on the fourth round. The only fight the man lost to the man opposite him now. In 1972 in a non-title fight in New York.
They each have one warning now for low blows. You know, as you pointed out, Ange, they say that Duran is a slugger. However, he's an unmarked slugger, which means he doesn't get hit too much. He's pretty cute in there.
Under 30 seconds in the fourth round. He is a hero in Panama.
That's a perfect confrontation. You know, guy boxing, guy slugger. Perfect confrontation of styles. Guys, that's why it's such a great fight.
Making a mistake, Gilly, slipping over to that right-hand side.
Final seconds of this fourth round. We'll return to more boxing action after this word from your local station. The fifth round of the World Lightweight Championship. Roberto Duran and Esteban De Jesus. De Jesus on the right of your screen. Judging in this fight by three judges, the referee Buddy Basilico will not participate in that. So he can make the final decision on any cut.
Esteban De Jesus was told his corner to box more, stick more jabs. So they're trying to get him to box.
And Richie Giacchetti told him, loosen up, relax. He says, you got him, just stay loose and box. A little holding and hitting. Oh, it's starting.
Here's Richie Giacchetti, one of the handlers of De Jesus, along with Manny Siaka, manager Jose Santiago.
Mistake of just thinking he had the guy hurt, Gilly. He took his time and tried to set him up for another punch.
Yes, he did. I'll
tell you, Andy Hayes fought right back.
We'll have more lightweight action on the CBS Sports Spectacular February 4th. Olympic champion Howard Davis, 5-0 in the pros against Jose Fernandez. February 4th, here on the CBS Sports Spectacular.
This fight's up for grabs the way he's going. You know what I mean? It looks like Duran hasn't gotten into stride yet. He's trying to get into the groove, and he hasn't come on yet.
I tell you, I noticed with Duran, he's starting to breathe heavy through his mouth. It could be that drying out and taking off all that weight, Angelo.
Well, it's because he's got a double mouthpiece still. That's what he's doing.
He's breathing heavily.
He's got a mouthpiece that looks a little tired.
I would say right now, the aces is the pressure of the two. I think one big punch can change this fight around.
There's
a good right hand by Duran.
A minute to go in the
fourth round. Duran always gives the impression of blow like that, Joe Brady. That's the way he fights. He breathes through his mouth. This is clear breathing. Each fighter has their own way.
Under 30 seconds remaining round five. Duran with 50 knockouts and 60 victories
In his last fight, he went the distance in a title match against Edwin Drury at Philadelphia back in September.
That could have been goodbye Charlie right there, that right hand by Duran. Match into the second.
Final seconds, round number five. Today, and of course, the resident of Las Vegas and a great fight fan. Roberto Duran in white against Esteban de Jesus in the sixth round, and they have been throwing from the opening bell.
This corner's doing an excellent job of getting the fighters ready between rounds. I like the way both of them work. They're picking the fighter up off the stool, giving him a little extra bounce to the ounce. They're doing a great job. I mean, they're getting the sisters in that corner real good.
All right, this is professional all the way.
Duran just landed a big bomb.
Right now I have Duran in control of the fight.
Esteban still keeps spreading open. See, this is a mortal sin against Duran. You can't spread open.
Now he's getting hurt.
He's getting hurt. He looked through his corner then. Look a little glazed, and I think that he gets hit. Great punch by Duran. Another right hand. And another one.
Right now, Duran is dishing it out, and De Jesus is taking it. He looks troubled. We're approaching the halfway mark of the sixth round.
Bombs at each other, and they're both lethal, so they both can punch. But Duran has got the inside track with the short shot, the right hand, and the left hook.
Yes, what he's doing, he's making the Jesus reach. He's slipping a punch, and he's stopping him with short punches. He's working upstairs and downstairs, and the Jesus is staying mostly to the head. I like those body punches.
Just realize Duran's been the strongest lightweight of all time. There's a guy that can punch you, move you, bang you under and over. Great champion.
Under a minute in round number six, scheduled for 15. Not too many people think it will go that far. The winner of this fight will be the undisputed lightweight champion of the world.
Say, De Jesus has to land a big one to get back in here, and that was just right now Duran is in control.
Buddy DeSilico, the referee, warning them to break what he tells them to. Keep those heads out from each other. Under 30 seconds in round six.
Good banging heads in there, Joe. And those little grooves on Esteban's right cheekbone. They're banging heads in there. That's what's going to cause a fight with either fight.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to see that happen.
Too great a matchup for something like that to happen. Let's hope it does. This is a classic. The final seconds of the sixth round. Duran and De Jesus in a rubber match. Responding to their champion, there are many Puerto Rican fans here too. Seventh round, Duran and White, De Jesus and Red.
This man seems looking for one punch. You can't do that with Duran because he can hurt you off the next shot, Joe. In other words, he's got to box his way into punches, and that's what he didn't do that last round. That's why Duran took charge real good in the last round.
Right now, Duran is the more relaxed fighter. He's slipping punches, getting in better position to punch. De Jesus has to reach him. When he reaches, he pays for it. Duran won his title back in 1972 over Tim Buchanan. De Jesus in 1976 over Ishimatsu Suzuki, the WBC crown.
You know, just about starting to show a little bit of tear on his face. He's got fusion under both eyes. And he's looking the weary of the two.
Yes, he is. He needs a big punch, and he's got to land one big one to really get back in this fight.
Well, either guy can, you know, not be the guy out, bro. You know, they're that kind of punches. That they should be, they want to show that they're both punches.
That was a vicious exchange. A good right hand to the body by Duran and a good left hook by De Jesus.
De Jesus, his nickname is Vita, V-I-T-A. Duran, Mano de Piedra, stone hands. I tell you, Duran's eyes look like two hot coals looking at me. I wouldn't want him looking at me like that. It's so intense.
trying to set something up, Gil. We see my playing his way right now, looking to set up a good punch, set up off a jab. This is the only way he's going to do it. So Duran, the discipline target, with his sliding in and out, very smart. Well, they have Duran. Duran is moving more this round, but the moving's not going to win him the rounds. He's going to, as you say, he's going to have to nail him with a good punch. He's going to have to set him up and get rid of one. Duran is in control. He's able to set his own pace. Very relaxed. Look at those eyes, Angel. Approaching the end of round number seven. Less than 30 seconds remaining now. A good move there, Joe. He's got to do more of that, in and out, side to side. Otherwise, see what he does now. He's playing cat and mouse with Duran. And Duran's going to do his pattern. Duran's going to pick up momentum. Otherwise, he's going to be in trouble. That's right. That's just like a chess game. That's what it's all about. Final seconds of the seventh round. Roberto Duran conducting business. How would you describe it, Gil? Those eyes are tight, like two hot coals. He's very, very intense. It's almost self-hypnosis. He doesn't see anything but DeJesus in that ring right now. Gil Clancy, Angelo Dundee, and Tim Ryan at ringside in Las Vegas, Nevada. We're in the eighth round of the World Lightweight Championship. If it doesn't end in the draw, we will have an undisputed lightweight champion of the world. Esteban is trying to set up a pattern, Gil. He's trying to keep Duran off balance, keep him off balance so he can't land a big punch. And he's trying to do it by moving. I tell you, Duran has been trying to reach with that right hand a little too much. I think he ought to go to the body a little more. In each of the last two fights, DeJesus had Duran on the floor in the first round. We have not seen anything approaching the knockdown punch so far by either fighter. The floor in the title fight in 1974 to knock DeJesus out the 11th round. Do they look strong to you at this point, Gil, Angelo?
They're both very strong. I think they're ready to go all night long. I think they're playing a good fight for themselves. But the thing is, they got it established where they're going to dominate the fight. No one's done that to me.
You've indicated you think Duran is in control.
Well, yes, you see that last body punch? That's going to help him in the late round.
Gil, he gets his legs together when he gets in the clinches. You notice?
That's right.
They come up together. He's on bounce. See the way they're together now?
Right. That left foot belongs forward. It belongs between the other fellow's legs. You get those feet even, you have no support, and you can't punch.
Now, Duran, you know what he did there, Gil? Left with a right hand, come back with a left foot. This is remarkable. He can do that all night long. That's the one point that reminds me of Rocky Marciano. Marciano used to throw right hand and miss you for 2 feet, make him back and knock you dead with a left hook.
Under 36 guys
did the same thing. There it goes there, Joe. See it? Switching his feet. Into a southpaw stand.
Final seconds of the eighth round. Duran and DeJesus really banging on each other.
To use a double jab. One jab and you can count it. If you use a double jab, you can keep the guy off balance. That's when you're worried about when you're fighting a punch. You tell your fighter to double the jab or triple it even. But don't throw one and hang out there.
I noticed in the corner that time, Gil, that Esteban took a nice swig of water. It means that the guy's getting a little tired. He's trying to drink the water instead of burgers flipping up.
Let's see if he pays attention to this corner. They told him to double his jab up. Now, so far this round twice, he's only thrown single jabs. He got counted. Let's see if he doubles it up.
So he's just on the right of his feet in the right of front. Help me!
when he throws a jab out there, lays it out there, Duran has to let it hook to the body, off that jab. He's got to shift that jab, let it go, and back out. Don't stay there.
That's right. It's stick and move is the name of the game.
So who would be undisputed champion? We'll find out tonight. I tell you, that was a great right hand uppercut by Duran, but De Jesus has taken these punches. He doesn't show any signs of wobble. I don't know about that, Bill. He got hurt the last shot. He's starting to show wear and tear around the eyes right now. I'm looking at the legs, Ange. They haven't shook yet.
That's in a minute remaining in the ninth round.
I tell you, as you pointed out, that Duran is a cute fighter. I mean, Esteban is a sharpshooter, and he just can't seem to hit Duran. Can't hit him with a solid punch.
Well, what impressed me, Gil, he's unmarked. This is a mark of a good fighter. Takes a good punch, he slides with a punch.
Under 30 seconds to go.
Right now, I have Duran in complete control of the fight. Esteban is going to have to make a big rally to get back in this fight and retain his championship.
Yes, I have Duran out front. I have Esteban winning about 3 rounds, the rest all Duran.
Seconds of the ninth round. This is round number 10 for the lightweight championship of the world, and during the ninth round, one of the handlers came around from the De Jesus corner, looked over the shoulders of Clancy and Dundee here, hoping to see how they were scoring the fight. He went back, and they were really talking to De Jesus between rounds.
Well, I'll tell you, he can't read my gibberish. He couldn't read the Clancy driver, so it don't make no difference. I have this fight, Duran actually in front, the way I feel, and it's up for grabs because both drivers don't line up. But wear and tear is taking over with DHZ. Right hand to the body, really hurt it. I tell you, that right hand lifted both of Esteban's feet off the floor about 1 foot. You talk about power and a punch. He's in great shape, Esteban, to be able to take these punches.
The little giants, they're called, lightweights at 135 pounds, but they throw punches like heavyweights.
It's remarkable. Duran knows he's got Esteban. He's showing it. Disdain. He's smiling now. He's starting to get on track, and he's starting to do his thing. Remarkable champion.
As punchers, can you compare these two, the previous great lightweight champions, both of you? Who do they remind you of, if anybody, and have any weight and punching power?
Well, no, Duran to me is a great. I mean, Duran has never got the accolades through him. He's been a great lightweight champion. He's came during the Muhammad Ali era. That's been the problem. The Monzan, you can defeat that and deal with Duran.
Some blood from the left nostril of the Jesus now.
I tell you, they're both getting a little long words because both of them are punching a little wider. I noticed on our last exchange that Duran's punches were, maybe 2-3 inches wider, which can be significant.
Jesus coming in right on the nose, and that's where he's already bleeding.
This round could be crushed. This is the beginning of the end.
A minute to go, round 10. Tim Ryan, Angelo Dundee, and Joe Clancy at ringside in Las Vegas, Nevada.
That was about as good a punch as Jesus landed in a fight that didn't bother Duran a bit.
The way Duran smiled at him when he got nailed,
great psychological move.
Yep.
The old Latin trick. When they get hit hard, they smile like that. And most of the other fighters, they say, "Why are you smiling?" They stop punching. That's when you got to really punch.
But they're both Latin, so they should know the trick. All right, he's looking to take his head off now.
Look how slick he is.
He looks awkward.
He slips those punches.
Under 30 seconds in the 10th round.
He slipped her right hand in orthodox, Gil.
He does right.
Now, you know he should slip the right hand like
that. He does it exactly the opposite. He pulls away and pulls over.
Final seconds of the 10th round. This is round number 11. You saw action there from the 10th round. The punching power of Roberto Duran in white.
This is the worst I've seen De Jesus. He's reaching now, missing punches, and he's getting hurt with each shot that Duran hits him with. So this is the sign that I don't think he can kick back from. I think the weight making is taking its toll.
Well, I tell you, this is where they separate the men from the boys. That's where they make championship fights 15 rounds. They enter the 11th round now. I've seen many, many a great champion after 10 rounds be even. But when they get in that championship stretch, that's when that championship heart and stamina comes out. And that's where I think Duran has the strength.
Joe Clancy, Angelo Dundee, and Tim Ryan here at Caesars Palace in Las Vegas, Nevada. We're inside watching the World Lightweight Championship. It is bright and sunny outside. I know many of you are looking from snowbound areas of the country. There's none here in Nevada, except high in the mountains.
There was another right hand to the body. Those are the punches that take the toll. A lot of times you don't see them. You don't say, well, why is he doing it? Believe me, that takes your breath away, takes your oxygen away, and it takes your stamina away.
A little mouse under the left eye of De Jesus now, apparently.
He's getting hit those body punches because he's falling in, Gil, and bringing both feet straight up, and that's a way to get nailed, a good right-hand body punch.
Well, he's a little tired now, Angel. Remember, everybody was worried about Duran making the weight, and you and I both sneak into the gymnasium. We saw De Jesus working the last day, which means he was having more trouble making the weight than Duran.
This is where it shows, Gil. No rings in the middle right there. This makes you want to tell who's the guy that's in the best shape and is ready for the fight.
There was the home run ball. He just missed it. Set him up and just missed it. We would have been counting 10.
A minute to go in the 11th round for the World Lightweight Championship.
Just heard him with a big right hand that's dropped to the body again, Joe. Sliding in again. Right hand climbing in the body. Wear and tear is taking hold of Esteban.
They brought it right up to the chin, same punch.
Duran beaten only once, that by De Jesus in the non-title fight 1972. 50 knockouts and 60 victories.
Good short right hand by De Jesus that time. He's got to take the offensive. He's got to start really doing something.
Jesus with a fair share of knockouts, 29 and 50 victories.
Oh, believe me, he can punch. But this fellow's always moving. Just moving that head a little bit. Takes a shot away from the punch.
We're in the final seconds now. Round number 11 in Las Vegas. That is concentration from Roberto Duran bearing down on his target, Esteban De Jesus. And so far as we've gone along, Duran seemingly taking a wide margin in the action so far as we are now in round number 12. Would you fellas agree? Where are they in this fight? You've got Duran ahead, both of you?
Yeah, Duran, I got Duran way in front. They sent Esteban out to get lucky this round. This is going to be the round whether he does it or not. He's got to take charge. He's got to win by a knockout. There's no way he's going to win any other way. He's too far behind.
That's exactly right. If I was in his corner, that's what I'd be telling him at the door. Look, you're going to have to go out there and gamble. Either knock him out or get knocked out, because he's not going to win the decision anymore. He's too far behind. Of course, we've seen some strange decisions in our days, too, Ange.
Well, I think we've seen a few, Gil, but I tell you, Duran's way in front, and Esteban is reaching for the guy, and he's already started to spread with the arm. So Duran's going to nail him again, Gil.
Get a reminder, those flashes you see are from flashbulbs here in the arena. Mainly amateur photographers trying to capture the excitement of one of the most anticipated championship bouts ever. Duran and De Jesus. We're under alert on our local stations along the line. We'll be going to a station break at the end of this 12th round.
Big right uppercut. Really almost put Esteban's head off it. Duran really taking charge now. He's controlling the fight. He opens up when he wants to. I think if he go a little bit out, I think he could stop DSU right now.
Duran has the record of defending his title and scoring 10 straight knockouts in title defenses. That is the record. And with him, now that he's ahead in the fight, he may not be satisfied unless he knocks the Jesus out.
He had to go 15 to beat Terry Walker on his last event.
That's correct. That broke the streak at 10.
Well, Tim, that's good for folks with 50 strokes. Really looked like great legs. You go all night long. Box you all night long. That's the kind of guy that gives the Duran trouble.
Take a swing at the guy thought better of it, which is fortunate for the young man.